Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to configure the React Progress Bar component using the Create React App command and Syncfusion EJ2 React Progress Bar package. Using the React Progress Bar control, you can indicate the progress of a task with customizable visuals. In this video, I will show you how to configure a few of this component's basic features, like different types of progress bars, states, ranges, and other customizations. Let's start with the application creation process. Make sure you have installed the latest version of React and Node in your system. I'll use VS Code as my editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. First, I create a new application in the command prompt using the npx create React App command and provide the app name, My React App. I want to create a React App with TypeScript, so let me add template TypeScript. It will only take a few seconds to create the project. Second, I navigate to the project location and install the Syncfusion Progress Bar package using the npm install Syncfusion EJ2 React Progress Bar command. Let's wait for a few seconds to complete the installation. Third, I open the project in VS Code. Before using the Syncfusion components, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. A license key is mandatory for React components to avoid license warnings. To see where to generate a trial license key, check the description below. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. To start using the control, I import it from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Progress Bar package and include the progress bar component tag. Then I add the custom height and width to the component. And these properties will be applied to the SVG element. Let me run this example and show you the progress bar. See here, a basic progress bar is rendered based on the specified height and width. Let's explore how to indicate progress using a progress bar. To indicate the progress, I need to add ranges and values to it. The default value of the range is 0 to 100. To customize it, I set the minimum property to 1, the maximum property to 50, and the value property to 25. See now, the progress bar indicates the progress value within the specified range. Let's see how to customize the track and progress thickness. To do that, I include the properties track thickness and progress thickness and set its value to 12. Checking now, the track and progress bar thickness has increased. Next, I change the color of the track and progress by setting custom color values to the track color and progress color properties. See, the progress bar color has been customized. To have stripes in the progress bar, include the isStripe property and set its value to true. The linear striped progress bar is rendered. Next, I will show you how to change the type of the progress bar. Progress bar can be rendered in linear or circular type. So far, we have seen the linear type. To render a circular progress bar, I include the type property and set its type to circular. I change the height and width property values to 160 pixels. Stripes are only for the linear progress bar, so I disable it. See here, a circular progress bar is rendered. Let's see how to add segments in the progress bar. To do that, add the segment count property and set its value to 8. Look now, a circular progress bar with segments is rendered. The same applies to the linear type as well. You can also customize the inner and outer radius of the circular progress bar. To demonstrate this, I include the radius property, set its value to 80%, and set the inner radius to 60%. The radius of the progress bar has changed. Next, we will move to the different states of a progress bar: determinant, indeterminate, buffer, and active. So far, we have seen the determinant state. If you cannot estimate the progress, then change to an indeterminate state by enabling the isIndeterminate property. Now, the progress is currently shown in an indeterminate state, with animation being enabled by default. To view both primary and secondary progress simultaneously, use the buffer state. I remove the isIndeterminate property, include the secondary progress property, and set its value to 40. The output displays the buffering progress. You can show progress value to the both linear and circular progress bars. Just enable the Show Progress Value property and set its value to true. Here, the progress value is shown in the progress bar. Annotations can also be included in a progress bar to mark the track area with text, shapes, or images. I import the progress bar annotations directive and progress bar annotation directive from Syncfusion EJ2 React Progress Bar package. To use this feature, I inject the progress annotation service in the progress bar component. Then add the progress bar annotations directive to include a list of annotations. And add a single progress bar annotation directive. Then I add the annotation content using the content property, set its value to loading. And disable the show progress value property. See now, an annotation has been added in the progress bar. Finally, I will show you how to animate the progress bar. To do that, I add the animation property and set the enable property value to true. To control the speed of the animation, include the duration property and setting its value to 2000 milliseconds. I set the delay property with the value 0. And now, the progress bar is animated based on the value provided. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure Syncfusion React Progress Bar component using the Create React App command and use a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.